So wish you all the best.
Thank you. Assalamu alaikum, everybody. And I know you. I cannot hear you, but I can see you. So to know whether you are all still alive, I want you to go to the chat box there, and I want you to say yes. Type there yes, so I know that you, everybody's there, still alive. There you go. There you go. So many yes coming out. Very good. Very good. Alhamdulillah. So that will be the most interactive way that you'll be interacting with me throughout this whole session. Yeah. Alhamdulillah. Since I'm made to be famous today in Bangladesh, I hope I'm famous for the right things. And Alhamdulillah, I've been going to Bangladesh doing programs for the past, 7-8 years already now. And this will be my first webinar with you. And I'm bringing to you my program called Take Charge. Take Charge, the program that you will be going through today with me, is a program which has been around for the past, 11 years, around the world in 9 countries. Among the companies in Bangladesh who have gone for this program is Coca-Cola Bangladesh. So you'll be going through the same program. It's just that it's an online version. It's a webinar version. So are you ready? If say ready, say why. Why means yes, short form for yes. Are you ready, everybody? Very good, very good. Alhamdulillah. Okay, so let's start. Take charge is about being responsible. And to have this attitude of take charge, you must have a reason why you want to take charge, because you cannot take charge all the time. If you take charge all the time, you're going to get very, very tired. For example, here you are relaxing on the beach at Cox Bazar. At that moment of time, I don't think you want to take charge. You want to relax. Yeah. So I'm going to show you how to switch on and take charge. Yeah. And it all starts with this question. What do you want in life now? A person who is take charge is a person who has a destination, is a person who knows where they want to go. So to have you having that take charge element within you, I'm going to ask this question to you right now. What do you want in your life right now? What one thing that you want in your life right now? Because everybody needs something. If you didn't need something, you wouldn't wake up today. So, how about everybody type one word that they want right now? You don't have to give me one long sentence. Give me one word. What do you want in your life right now? So, chat box. Some people say control. Okay. Happiness. Health. Peace. Yeah, everybody wants that. Yeah, health. There's so many health there. Stability, peace. Yes. Give me one more. Peace and happiness. There's two things. Achievement, safety, honor. Very good. So we all want something. Yeah. Everybody needs something. So the first element of a take charge person is that person must have a destination. That person must have a goal, something they want to achieve. Yeah. Now, here's the next question. How do you feel about it? For example, you say, I want health. So how do you feel about that? Answer the question. How do you feel about what you want? You said you want A. Okay. How do you feel about it? Do you feel good about it? Do you feel sad about it? Do you feel disappointed because you haven't got it yet? How do you feel about it? Some people say positive. Okay. How do you feel about it? I want health. Okay, so how do you feel about it? Optimistic, hopeful. Okay. Sometimes good, sometimes bad, says Anjun. Good, hopeful. Scientists say emotion drives behavior. If you want something, but you don't feel anything, then it will not drive you towards it. Yeah. So every time you want something, you must have an emotion which goes with it. Now, that emotion doesn't have to be hopeful, good, positive all the time. Yeah, it may be a negative emotion. For example, I want money, but I feel disappointed. And that's okay. It's okay. Yeah, at least you have a feeling, because that feeling will help drive you towards it. Some people want to go to Jannah, to heaven, because some people, everybody wants to go to Jannah. Everybody wants to go to heaven. But some people do good, they go to heaven. Some people, they're afraid of hell. It drives them to do good. Again, some people, they do good because they want to go to heaven. Some people, they're afraid of hell. They do good. So either your emotion is a positive emotion or a negative emotion, is okay. Right now, I want you to write the emotion. You wanted something, what's the emotion with it? Because at the end of this whole take charge session, we want to see whether that emotion changed. So to help you remember what emotion you had at the start of the program, I want you to write down what emotion you have right now on your piece of paper, wherever you are right now. Okay? All right. So let's go to the next. Now, you say you want something. Now, here's the question. What's stopping you from getting it? I want you to list down 5 reasons. Now, you don't have to list down on the chat box for this one. Yeah? List it down on your piece of paper. List down 5 reasons. What's stopping you from getting, some of you want happiness, what's stopping you from getting happiness? List down 5 reasons, what's stopping you from getting money? List down 5 reasons, what's stopping you from getting whatever you wanted? Yeah? I want you to list down that 5 reasons now. I'll give you time. The time starts now. Seconds. Fifteen seconds. Coming up, seconds. Three, there you go. All right. So, what's stopping you? Give me one. What's stopping you? Myself, okay? Responsibility, situation, procrastination, says Mayan. What's stopping you? Give me one more. What's stopping you? Oh, money situations, myself, 3. Lack of drive, says Naihan. Own capability. COVID-19. Yeah, that's stopping a lot of people today around the world. Fear of failure, fear. All right, all this that you're writing down, you're telling me, you know what we call it? We call it, do you know what we call it? We call it reasons. We call it excuses. Yeah? In my program, we call it bangau. You know what a bangau is? Yeah? A bangau is a bird, something like this. If you can see this bird we are bringing you. Can you see this bird there? There you go, more or less. Yeah? There you go. In your country, you call it bok. Yeah? How many of you know the bok bird? Say why. Put a why there. Yeah, very good. You normally, why as in yes. Yeah. In my country, the bird you call bok, in my country we call bangau. And in my country we have a song called the bangau song. Let me tell you the bangau song in English. Yeah? Bangau o bangau, why are you so thin? The bangau answers, I am so thin because the fish won't come up. Fish, why you not come up? Because the grass too tall. Grass, why you too tall? Because the buffalo didn't eat me. Buffalo, why you not eat the grass? Because the, why the buffalo didn't eat the grass? Because my stomach ache, stomach, why you ache? Because the rice was not cooked well. Rice, why you not cook well? Because the firewood was wet. Firewood, why you wet? Because the rain came down. Rain, why you come down? Because the frog called me. Frog, why you call the rain? Because the snake want to eat me. Snake, why you want to eat the frog? Because it's my food. You see, in that song, how we tend to give excuses and blame, especially when we don't get what we want in life. So in my session, in the Take Charge session, I say, stop bangawin. Stop giving excuses. Yeah, let me type here for you when I say stop bangawin, how it looks like. Yeah. There you go. Sorry. Bangawin. There you go. Yeah, in the chat box. Stop bangawin. Stop giving excuses. Every time you give an excuse, it will stop you from getting what you want. And the worst among us will give excuse of everything. Yeah. For example, why were you late? Oh, because there was a traffic jam, so they bangau the jam. Some people say, why didn't you wake up early this morning? Oh, because the alarm clock didn't ring, so they bangau the alarm clock. Some people even worse. Why didn't you get the promotion? Oh, because it was fated that way. Who decides on fate? Who decides on fate? God. That means they bangau God. So be careful. Stop bangawi. Yeah? Because bangau is that evil of all achievements. No more giving excuses. See? Oh, actually the alarm clock was not set. Yeah, who sets the alarm clock? You. So stop bangawing the alarm clock. Be responsible and take charge. So let's move on. Stop bangawing. No more excuses. Time to take charge. All right, here's the next question. What achievements have you had in your life? We all have had achievements, either big or small. Yeah? I want you to list down three now. What achievements have you had in your life? And when I say list down for yourself. Yeah, list down for yourself. I'm going to give you 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right. For those of you who are ready, who have already listed down three, I want you to type in the chat box 3. Type in the chat box the number 3. Meaning you've already listed out 3. 3. There you go. Yeah. So some of you listed out achievements in terms of you have a family. That's an achievement. Yes, of course. Some of you, you listed out, you're now a trainer. Your education, you got a degree. That's an achievement. Yeah. So you know what this proves? By listing out your achievements, at least three, what you've done, if you can do one thing, then you can do another. Meaning, if you have had an achievement in your life before, then you can achieve some more. Yeah? No more excuses. No more reasons that you cannot achieve some more. Because you have had a track record of achievements. At least three. And inshallah, if you really take the time to list out, I'm sure you can list out more than three. So, stop bagawi. No more excuses. Now, those achievements that you list out, look at the next question. Did the achievement come about by choice or luck? For example, you went for your interview and you got a job. That's an achievement, yes? was it by choice or did you get the job by luck? Answer that question at the chat box. How many of you say choice? How many of you say luck? Choice. Oh, some people say luck. Choice. There's a lot of choice there. Very good. Choice. Luck. Very good. Now we need to understand what does it mean, yeah? When we say by choice, what is it? What does it mean by choice? For example, let's say once upon a time ago, you had no job. You were sitting at the side of the road, not doing anything, no job. And then suddenly a car drives by, stops. Somebody pulls down the window and say, "Do you have a job?" When you say, "No job, sir." "No job? You come into my car and we go into my company." Did that happen to you? Of course you didn't. So how did you get a job? Number one, you choose to apply. Number two, you choose to send your resume. Number three, when they call you for the interview, you choose to attend. When they ask you questions during the interview, you choose to answer. You choose what words to use, how to say those words. You choose how you dress, how you wore that tie, what color you use, you choose. So whether you got the job or you didn't, you don't know yet. This is what we call fate, things which you don't know. But you choose first. Where is luck? Every moment is a choice. Ladies and gentlemen, as you're seeing these words, I want you to write it down. Write it down on a piece of paper near you. Every moment is a choice. And we learned this sentence since we were in primary one. Every moment is a choice. We know this. But our teachers always forgot to tell us the secret second sentence. What's the secret second sentence? Every choice is my choice. I chose those. It is my choice, which led me towards that situation. Either the situation was good or situation was bad, it is still a choice which I made. So you want to be responsible for that. Let's not talk about fate. Fate is beyond your control. Yeah, Allah decides on fate. Yeah? It's beyond your control. So let's talk about things within your control. And this is called choice. So the question now is, what's luck? What is this thing called luck? I want you to give me one situation. One situation, one simple situation. You don't have to elaborate so long. Give me one simple situation which you feel, this is luck. Don't give me a definition. Give me a situation. I'll give you 20 seconds to do this. Ready? Oh, won lottery. That's a good example. All right. Thank you. Now let's take this example by Amina Avros. Yeah. She says, winning the lottery, that's luck. Think about it. To gamble or not to gamble is a choice. Yes? All right, let's say 1% he chooses to gamble. He could choose lottery, he could choose horses, he could choose to go to Macau. Yeah, there's a lot of gambling there. Let's say he chooses lottery. He could choose lottery A or lottery B or lottery C or lottery D or lottery whatever lottery. Yeah. In fact, he chooses the numbers. Now, whether he won a prize or didn't win a prize, we don't know yet. This is what we call fate, things which you don't know. But you choose first. So we got luck. Noir here writes, random selection. Yeah, of course, random selection. It is a selection. It is a choice. So there is no luck. Yeah, this concept of luck is not there. Life is full of choices. Yeah. Please write down this sentence. Because you want to put it up somewhere, maybe on your fridge, yeah, on your refrigerator or the wall somewhere. You want to always remind yourself, for a take charge person, life is always full of choices. So choose. In Malaysia here, we say choose lah. Because every choice you make is right. For example, when you woke up this morning, did you say, oh, today I want to do something very bad? Today I want to choose to do something very bad. Did you do that? No. Yeah, you chose that. Or for example, when you drive a car and you see the traffic lights turning yellow, but still you drive through. Why? Because you want to be there early. Yeah. That thing, even though it's wrong, you choose it because it's right for you. So every choice you make is right. Have faith. Yeah. That's why you choose A, not B, because it felt right for you. So life is full of choices. Choose. Let's go to the next point. To achieve what you want, would you face problems? How many of you answer this question with a yes? Put Y in the chat box. To achieve what you want, would you face problems? Yes. 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 There you go. Now, I want you to now list down three problems when you move house. You know, right now you stay in one house and then suddenly you buy another house and you now want to move house. When you move house, do you have problems? I want you to list down three problems when you move house. I'm going to count, give you 10 seconds for it. Very, very simple. Give me three problems when you move house. Packing, transfer belongings. Expenses, money, of course. Shifting, logistics, yes. You get the lorry, transportation, of course. Fear you bought the wrong house. Yeah. Maybe the wrong neighbors. Yeah. So here's the point. When you move house, there will be problems. So question. Why do you move? Why do you move in the first place? When you move house, there will be a problem. Yeah, understand. Why do you move? Cannot hear me. Can you hear me, everybody? Not clear? Clear. Can you hear me? Echoing. Can you hear me now? Yes. Okay, now everybody can hear me. All right. So let's go back to this question. You want to move house? You say you have a lot of problems. Yes, we agree. Question is, why do you move? Convenience, okay. Some people say there, Shawon wrote convenience to move forward. Yeah, of course. Why do you move? For better environment, yeah. Better place, very good. Oh, there's a long one. Okay. Why do you move? Now, all this that you wrote up, growth, office move, let's take this by Amina Afros again. She says, maybe office move. So that means you are forced to move. Nah, you're not forced to move. You're never forced to do anything. It is always based on a choice. Yeah. You choose to follow your boss's instruction. Even though you didn't like it, still, it was still a choice. So here's the point now. Here's the point I'm making now. The reasons that you mentioned, yeah, the reasons are what we call intentions. Yeah. The reason you move is your intention. Yeah. So if you say, the reason I move
to this particular place because it's, I want a new environment. That's your intention. Yeah. So a person who is take charge is a person who clarifies what intentions they have. They know what they want. And these intentions are very, very clear for them. Because if the intention is not there, then whatever goals you have in your future will be very, very difficult. For example, when you are running in a race, how many, there will be a finishing line, yes? There will be a destination, yeah? Now, the thing is, in a race, there are not one line. There is two lines, the finishing line and the starting line. Many people out there, when they think about having things in their life, the achievements they want in their life, they're always thinking about the finishing line. But because their intentions at the starting line is not clear, then they will never get there. And when problems come their way, they lose their way because the problems distract them. So get your intentions clarified. Now, you told me at the start of the whole session that you have something to achieve. Some of you said health, some of you said wealth, some of you said family, some of you said work. Okay, what's your intention? I want you to write down three intentions that you have. Write down three intentions that you have to achieve something. This now, at the start of this session, I told you to write down what you want to achieve. Okay? What's your intention to get there? There you go. Disease free for my son. There you go. Alhamdulillah. Okay. When you say Masood, when you say good intention, what is it? What's your intention? Yeah. For example, I want to make a lot of money. That's my destination, my achievement, my goal. My intention is I want to be able to give more zakat, more infaq, more sadaqah. That's my intention. So because my intention is that and my destination is clear, yeah? Get your intentions right. Now, my brothers and sisters here from Bangladesh, one of the best intentions, in fact, you can have so many intentions. The first intention should be always lillahi ta'ala, yeah? Always relate it to God, yeah? Because everything must be related to God, yes? All right, let's go to the next point, to be that take charge person. Are we ready, everybody? If you say yes, say yes. Yes, very good, very good, very good. Let's go to the next point. When your intentions are clear, your problems fade away. There will be problems in life. No problem, no fun. You will have problems in life. But when your intentions are clear, the problems do not become problems. They just become challenges, things that you have to go through, obstacles that you have to go through to get to your destination. Now, there are three kinds of problems. If you look at my slide, I put there some boxes there, yeah, these boxes here. There are three kinds of problems. Some problems come from me, yeah, from yourself. Yeah. Examples, problems which come from yourself, for example, I do not know how to speak English correctly. Is that a problem for some of us? Yeah, for some of us, yes, it is a problem. But can you solve that problem? I do not know how to speak English correctly. Can we solve this problem? Yes or no? Yes. Yes, of course. How? Learn. Yeah. Watch TV without the subtitle. Sing songs. Marry an English man or English woman. Yeah. So, I do not know how to speak English correctly. Exactly. English is not rocket science. Exactly. Can be solved. So problems which come from me can be solved. Yeah. All right. So watch that box. Watch that box. Here's the second box. Second type of problem. Problems within my control. What are problems within my control? For example, I have no money. That's a problem I'm sure many of us are going through right now. I have no money. Can that problem be solved? Yes or no? Can that problem be solved? Yes or no? Yes. Yes. How? Ready? Yeah. Work. Do business. Do part-time work. Do Uber. Yeah. Do something. Steal. Is that a choice? Yes, it is a choice. But stealing would lead you to jail. But it's a choice. Yeah. So problems within my control can also be solved. So problems from me can be solved. Problems within my control can also be solved. Now here's another problem. Third type of problem. Problems beyond my control. For example, you want to go to work and it's raining heavily. Is that a problem? You want to go to work? It's raining heavily. Is that a problem? Yes or no? Yes. Yeah. Can the problem be solved? Yeah. How? Umbrella, for example. Yeah. Take the car, for example. Don't go to work, for example. Yeah, maybe. You have many choices. So here's the point. Problems beyond my control, work from home, very good, yeah, can be solved. So problems for myself can be solved. Problems within my control can be solved. Problems beyond my control can be solved. So here's the secret. Every problem has a solution. A take charge person doesn't take a problem as the cut-off point. A take charge person takes a problem as a challenge because they know that every problem has a solution. We learn this in for those of us who are Muslims, we learn this in Islam. Every disease has a cure. Very good. There you go. Very good. Has a remedy. Has a cure. Very good. Even COVID, is that the cure hasn't come yet, yeah? So have faith. No problems, no fun. So what do you do when you have problems? Have fun. It's like when you watch a cricket match and the opposite team keeps quiet, not moving at all. Will you have fun? No fun. It'll be the most boring match in the world. So no problems, no fun. When we have problems, what do? Have fun. Every problem has a solution, and every solution begins with me. You want to write this down. This is another sentence, yeah, that you want to always remember. Every problem has a solution, and every solution begins with me. It doesn't necessarily come from me, but it begins with me. For example, let's say I have a burst pipe in my toilet. Yeah, the tap is leaking, for example. I have a choice to repair it on my own. I have a choice to call the plumber. I have a choice to use the sellotape. I have a discharge. I have so many choices. Every problem has a solution. I have so many choices, many solutions. But it is me who solves the problem. It is me who calls the plumber. It is me who puts the sellotape. It is my choice. So every solution begins with me. So no more bangau. No more excuses. Stop bangauing. Let's go to this next point. How much effort does it take for you to be better than today? How much effort do you really think that it takes you to be better than today? You see, a person who is take charge wants to go places. There's a destination. But if he or she is the same person tomorrow, then you're not going to get anywhere because you're going to stay in the same place because it's the same you. So how much effort does it take for you to be better than today? Sajia says lots of effort. Amina says learning has no limit. Very good. Okay. Bishwagi says it depends. Consistent effort, not much. Least effort. Yeah. Ashikur says least effort. Well, tell me, in a race, a 100-meter race, there are 8 runners. How many people get number one? Again, the situation. In a race, there are 8 runners, a 100-meter race. How many people get number one? Maiden answer, one. There's only one person. Yeah, exactly. One person only gets to be number one. And this person who became number one, he or she became number one. Why? Because he or she ran 0.1 second faster than number two. Just a little more effort. You just need a little more effort to become better than yesterday. And that little more effort may be doing your salat on time, doing your namaz on time, for example. Yeah, that little bit more effort means getting that report done one day earlier, for example. Little more effort maybe playing with the kids a bit more time, yeah? Spending more time with the kids, for example. It doesn't take much to become better than yesterday. Just a little more effort. So don't more bangal. Because for some people, they feel that to become better than yesterday, they need to put a lot of effort. No, it just takes a bit more effort. So no more bangal. Nothing stopping you. Yes, just give some extra effort. There's a little bit more effort. All right. Are you ready for the next question? Are you still with me? Yes or no? Say why for yes. Very good. Stretch your hands a bit. Yeah. Learning online is a big thing, yeah? All right. Here's the next question for take charge person, yeah? When you were a kid, when you were small, when you were young, what were your ambitions? Everybody, I mean, for those of you who have children, I'm sure you go and ask your son or daughter, what do you want to be when you grow up? So, here's your question. When you were a kid, what were your ambitions? Okay, let's see some of you. Oh, some of you wanted to be, Arif wanted to be a pilot. Pilot at the school of life, very deep. Yeah. What was your ambition? Pilot also, yeah. I want to be a detective. Doctor, says Nafia. Okay. Sadia, I want to own TV. Have your own TV. Astronaut, says Rafi. Very good. Engineer. To be a good man, Mahfuz. Oh, Alhamdulillah. Mahfuzo says, I want to be a good man. That was his ambition. When he was a kid, leader of corporate sales. Swat. Wow. Singer. Alhamdulillah. Okay, so here's the question. Are you that person today? No. Are you that person today? No. Everybody says no. Okay. So what happened? You see, goals in life must be very clear. If it's not clear, then you don't know whether you reach there or not. You don't know whether you're going the right way. For example, if you are from Dhaka and you are driving towards the airport, how do you know you've reached the airport? There is a landmark. There is a signboard. Yeah. They are signs. Exactly. So when you were small, and when your parents ask you, what do you want to be? And some of you say, I want to be a doctor. But your parents forgot to ask you the secret second question. What doctor? Yeah. Eye doctor? Heart surgeon? Dentist? Animal doctor? What doctor? The goal was not clear. Oh, I want to work in a corporate company. Some of you say when you were young. Okay, doing what? Nobody asked you the follow-up question. Everybody forgot. Even the teachers that you had, they all forgot to ask you the follow-up question. What do you want to do specifically? So because your goals were not clear, when there were problems in your life, then you get distracted. And some of you reached the goals and most of you missed out on the goal. So when you say a take charge person must have ambitions, must have something they want to work towards, that destination must be crystal clear. When I say crystal clear, I'm going to give you some tips on how to get your goals clear, which you can also use on your children, yeah? So the next time you ask your children, what do you want to be when you grow up? You can start asking this same tips that I'm going to give you so that their goals will be crystal clear. So as they grow up in life, they'll have that ambition, they'll have that motivation to achieve their goals. All right. So here are the tips. I'm going to give you 7 tips. You can write this down, or later on you can take the recording of this whole session and you can relook at it. But simple tips. Yeah, I am going to give you 7 tips. Tip number 1, write what you want, not what you don't want. Again, I'm going to repeat. Write what you want, not what you don't want. Now, let me explain what this means. For example, let's say you go to a restaurant, a fast food restaurant, McDonald's, for example. Yeah. And when you go to McDonald's, you go to the counter, the person behind the counter is asking you, what do you want? What do you want to eat, sir? And you say, I don't want burger, I don't want fries, I don't want chicken, I don't want salad. By the time you come to the number 5, the person behind the counter is already screaming, what do you want, sir? So say what you want, not what you don't want. My late mother, when she was young, people asked her, who do you want to marry? And she answered, I don't want to marry a guy whereby his house is in the middle of the paddy field. My father, his house was right in the middle of the paddy field. What you don't want, you get. So always write what you want. So not what you don't want. For example, instead of saying, I don't want to be poor, you say what? What do you say? I don't want to be poor. What do you say? I want to be? Come on, write on the chat box. I want to be rich. Very good. Very good. I don't want to be sick. What do you write? I don't want to be sick. I want to be healthy. Very good. I don't want to be late. What do you write? I want to be on time. I want to be early. I want to be punctual. Very, very good. Very, very good. So remember tip number 1 now. Write what you want, not what you don't want. Here we go. Are you ready for tip number 2? Say yes. Very good. Tip number 2. Be as detailed, as specific as possible. Again, I repeat. Be as detailed, as specific as possible. Let me give you an example to explain this. For example, you go to that McDonald's fast food restaurant, as you go to the counter, and you say, I want to eat. The person behind the counter will say, eat what, sir? And you say, eat burger. And the person behind the counter will respond, which burger, sir? And he will ask as many questions as possible until he understands what we want. Then he knows to get which burger that we want. So be as detailed as possible. So for example, I want to buy a car. Is that clear? Tell me. No, it's not clear. Yeah, exactly. It's not clear. What car? What's the brand of the car? First hand or second hand? What color? Automatic or manual? Very good. Now, some people say, I want to lose weight. But every year they put on more weight. Yeah, you know why? Because they're not specific. You want to lose weight to what kilogram? When do you want to start losing weight? When you want to reach the weight you want? You want to be that clear? I want to be a house. I want to buy a house. Is that clear? No. What house? How big is this house? Where will the house be? Where? Gulshan 1, Gulshan 2, Gulshan 3, Gulshan 4, which one? You want to write so specific until you can see the color of the walls. So tip number 2, be as detailed, as specific as possible. I want to be a corporate leader of a top reputed brand. That still must be specific. Reputed brand? What? Coca-Cola is a reputed brand. GE is a reputed brand. Bangla Link is a reputed brand. What do you mean specifically? Yeah. Be as detailed as possible. Yeah. All right. Are you ready for tip number 3? Say yes. Very good. Tip number 3. Write with faith. Again, write with faith. Now, when we talk about faith, it's like faith in yourself, faith in the knowledge and skills that you have, faith in the people around you, they will be supportive, faith in the economy, faith in the government, faith in God. Write with faith. Now, here's the question. Where is faith? Is it in your head or in your heart? Please answer in the chat box. Where is faith? Is it the head or the heart? Yes. Many people put their heart. Yes, you are correct. It is in the heart. What does it mean? It means when you want something, you must feel for it. Because faith is in the heart. You must feel for it. Let me give you an example. For those of you who are married now, once upon a time ago, you were not married. And you had many, for the male friends or female friends, you have many of them. Friends, just friends. Yeah. And from those many male friends and female friends, there was one person who touched your heart. This is what we mean. That one person. You feel for. So when you want to get your goals clear, you want to be specific, so specific until you feel for it. Remember, I told you, the scientists say emotion drives behavior. If you don't feel for it, you're not going to get there. So write with faith. Here we go. Tip number 4. Write using confident words. Write using confident words. Now, what's confident words? Let me tell you about words which are not confident words. Yeah? For example, try. Try is a not confident word. Yeah. But let me give you an example. Try. All right, everybody, I'm watching you on your cameras now. Yeah, I want you. I'm watching you on the camera now. I want you to try to touch your nose with your finger now. Try to touch your nose. That is touch, Ashikur. You touch your nose. This is touch. I say try to touch. Yeah, you cannot try to touch. It's either you touch or you don't. There's no try. So, I will try to be successful. That's not clear. That's not confident. I will try to be rich. That's not confident. So, when you write the goals that you want in life, do not use these not confident words. Yeah? Use confident words. I can. I want to. Yeah. How about I think? I think, is that a confident word? I think. No, exactly. That's not a confident word. For example, you meet a guy in the middle of the middle of Dhaka, late at night, and you go to the guy, and then the guy says, "I think I'm a man." You will be running the other way. Yes, it's a very confusing word. Yes. Yeah. So no such thing. I think I can be rich. No, that's not confident. I can. I want to. So write using confident words. All right? So I gave you four tips. I've already given you four tips. I still owe you three more. I give you four tips. Let's do a simple exercise. Using these first four tips, I want you to review what you want to achieve. Remember at the start of this program, at the start of this program that we are having right now, I told you to write down something that you wanted to achieve. Now, using the four tips I'm giving you, I want you to review what you want. So for those of you, for example, I want a good health. Okay, use the four tips now to review what you want. Make it as specific as possible. I'm going to give you about 1 minute to do this. Using the four tips, review what you want in life to make it more specific. Are you ready? Let's begin now. Review what you wrote earlier using the four tips. I'm now going to continue with tip number five. Yeah. Say it out with emotion. You see, whatever you want in life, you wrote it down just now. But you see, that's in your heart. You need to say it out. Yeah. And when you say it out, you must say it out with emotion. Whatever you want in life, you cannot get alone. You need people's help. So you need to tell people. If you don't tell people, then how are people going to help you? There are a few secrets when you tell people what you want in life. Secret number one, you never know that person may be the person who can help you out. If you don't tell them, how would they be able to know? Yeah, so secret number one, when you tell somebody, that person you tell may be the person who is able to help you out. Secret number two, even though that person doesn't know how to help you, at least that person will make dua, make prayer for you. So tell people what you want say it out with emotion. So one of the homework after this session, this take charge session, you want to go around with people in your house or your family members and you tell them what you want. Yeah, with emotion, with feeling. You say, I want to buy a car, no feeling. Nobody's going to listen to you. Yeah, you want to say it with emotion. Tip number 6. Are you ready with tip number 6? Say yes. Very good. Ready? Tip number 6. Always update your goals. Again, always update your goals. Now, what does it mean by update? For example, let's say right now you write down your goal is I want to be a healthy person, for example. Yeah. A week after this program, a month after this program, revisit that goal and update the goal. Put in a deadline. I want to be a healthy person. It means I want to lose weight to 40 kilograms, for example, to 60 kilograms, for example. Yeah. Always update your goals. Now, this is very important. Why? Because you see, everything in life changes frequently. So if your goals don't change a week or a month later after you wrote them, then those goals will die. So always update your goals. Tip number 7. When you achieve your goals, quickly make new goals. Again, when you achieve your goals, quickly make new goals. Now, you know, once upon a time ago, when you were still studying in your universities, and I'm sure all of you had the goal, I want to be able to work in the corporate company. And you achieved that goal. You got the job. But because you did not make a new goal, then you were staying in that position, in that company for the rest of your life. Because you didn't make a new goal. Yeah. Many people in universities right now, many people in the primary school right now, I want to get into a university. And they achieve their goal. But once they get into university, after year one in university, they get out of the university. Why? Because their goal is just to achieve, to get into the university, not to graduate. So once you achieve your goals, quickly make new goals. Or not, your mind will recycle the old goal. There you go. So 7 tips for you. If you find all these 7 tips interesting to get your goals clear, say yes. Very good. Alhamdulillah. May these tips be useful to you, inshallah. Now, we're nearing the hour. Tell me how you feel now. Is it different compared as to how you felt at the start of the program? Is there a difference? Alhamdulillah. Yes, yes. Alhamdulillah. Huge yes. Alhamdulillah. Yes, yes. Alhamdulillah. Very good. This feeling that you're having is what I call the take charge feeling. This change that you're feeling right now is what I call the take charge feeling. This is what take charge feels like. It makes you, it drives you. It makes you want to do better. It makes you to be, you know, to be better than yesterday. It makes you want to shout out loud, these are the things that you want to do. So these are the tips to become that take charge person. By getting your goals clear, by making sure that all these things that you wrote were because of choices that you made. Will there be mistakes in life? Will there be problems in life? Yes, there will be problems in life. No problem, no fun. And we learn this. Every problem has a solution, and every solution begins with me. So no more bangao. No more excuses. Get my goals clear. Get my intentions right. Get my intentions clear. get my destination clear, and then move and act using the 7 tips that I mentioned about. Yes, it is really excited when you share your goals with people. Now, some people will say, if I share my goals with people, they will make fun of me. They will laugh at me. You know, my advice to those people is, go find new friends. You do not need toxic people in your life. Yeah, go find new friends. Now, there's so many of you, and I'm sure you have many questions. Yeah. If you want a personal answer from me, you go to my FB page. No, go to your FB page first. Yeah. And I want you to share your experience about this learning that you had with me through Omnisource. You tag me, you can tag Omnisource. Write your experience, tag me. And once I get that tag, I will contact you on Messenger to schedule a private session with you. You may ask me face to face, or you may even email me. Yeah. You want my email address? You can go to my website. This is my website. Yeah, right down there, right down here, take-charge.com.my, or you can also email to Omnisource and they will send the questions to me. Yeah. Yes, you can have my PowerPoint. Yes, I will share it with Omnisource and you can get it from them, or you email me directly and I'll share my PowerPoint with you. I'm using Keynote, I would have to change it to PowerPoint. How many of you are on Twitter? Say yes. How many of you on Twitter? Yeah, follow me on Twitter, please. How many of you on Instagram? Yes, very good. Follow me there also. You can also follow me on YouTube. I have my own channel there. And on Facebook. Facebook, you have to only follow me to become friends. It will take a long time. Thank you very much for the experience. Alhamdulillah. Thank you very much for the experience. May everybody be safe and healthy through all these times. Yeah.